What are some of the common problems I hear with patients who are doing orthokeratology? In this video, I discuss some of those problems and what you might be able to do about it. The first problem I hear is that the patient or child just complains that the lenses don't feel very good. They feel like, they feel very uncomfortable when they put the lenses on. And maybe they didn't feel that way yesterday, but they feel that way today about it. Usually what happens is with these hard lenses, if you get just a tiny piece of dust underneath the lens, even just for a moment in time, and you put that in your eye, it's extremely, extremely uncomfortable. Usually the solution is quite simple. I would take out the lens, probably rinse it with a saline or like a multi-purpose contact lens solution, and then don't use tap water. Rinse it with a sterile saline is the best. And then I would put a little eye drop in the lens, like an artificial tear. For instance, one of my favorite ones is Refresh Celluvisc. And that will help kind of coat the lens and make it more smoother to put it in and more comfortable. So usually if patients just take out the lens, rinse it, put an eye drop in it, and put it back on their eyes, most of the time it feels better right away. And that's usually the best solution. If it still feels bad, even if you're wearing it for multiple days in a row and it just feels extremely uncomfortable, I would stop wearing the lenses and see your doctor and ask them about what, and have them check what's and see what's going on. So the first problem is discomfort while wearing the lenses. Another common problem is that maybe your vision is still blurry even after doing orthokeratology. Like it's okay, it's better, but it's not quite right. You're getting some problems at nighttime, for instance, and the vision is not as good as it should be. That could happen for a variety of reasons. First of all, orthokeratology is just it reshapes the cornea temporarily. It's not permanently changing your eyes like a surgery. So there are some pros and cons. It's not surgery, but at the same time, it's not something that is permanent. The second problem I see with orthokeratology, some of those patients complain that their vision is not as good as they want it to be. They've got problems at nighttime with the halos around lights. Maybe the vision is still not as clear as they saw before with regular glasses and contact lenses. A few of the reasons why that can happen is the lens just needs to be redesigned. The treatment is not properly centered in your eye. Maybe we didn't correct everything fully. It didn't quite fit right. I would see your doctor, see if they can redesign the lenses to make your vision any better. Now, sometimes your doctor has already redesigned the lens multiple times and your vision still can't get where you want it to be. There are a few reasons why that can happen. First of all, orthokeratology is a little bit unpredictable sometimes because you're wearing it every night. It's reshaping your eye. But the human body sometimes just reacts differently depending on the day, depending on how you sleep. Are you sleeping on your side, on your back? How long you slept, for instance? Did you put the lens on and wear them while awake? In general, you want to wear the lenses only while sleeping, lying down, preferably on your back. If you do those things and your vision is still bad and you're not happy with it, and your doctor has tried to redesign the lenses, if you're not happy, maybe orthokeratology is not right for you because there are some limitations in the technology, and about 2% of the patients would rather just wear their regular glasses again. The last thing that can happen with orthokeratology is, especially in children, the goal is that it's supposed to stop the eyes from getting worse or slow down the progression of myopia, stop the eyes from growing too long. We call it the axial length. Stop it from growing too long in the axial length. Some patients still grow and their eyesight still diminishes. The goal of orthokeratology is not to stop the eyes from getting worse, even though that would be nice, it's just to slow it down. And so if that's happening, usually what happens is, at least on a yearly basis, the eye doctor that you see should look and see and measure how long your eyeballs are, how long the axial length is, find out if your eyesight is still progressing despite being treated with orthokeratology, and at that time they usually need to resize the lenses. They need to re-change the shape of the lens to treat your myopia that's progressed. And then you should be fine afterwards. So those are the common problems with orthokeratology. If you want to learn more about orthokeratology, you can certainly visit our website at www.insightvisionoc.com and click on the link, orthokeratology.